join me in welcoming Yu Suzuki.
Yu Suzuki, I almost consider him the Shigeru Miyamoto of Sega. This guy just had really great ideas for games, and simple ideas, but they were fun ideas.
The Japanese studios were built almost like oligarchs. You'd walk down the street with Yu Suzuki or Yuji Naka or Nagoshi-san, and you'd be mobbed in Akihabara.
And so you knew that when you sat down in the arcade and you saw a new game from Sega, in particular that was being directed by Yu-san, it was always pushing the limit. And I remember hearing about Yu Suzuki was moving away from arcades and was going to make his first consumer-focused console game, and it was a Virtual Fighter RPG.
その時に鈴木優さんはやっぱりいわゆる日本にあるロールプレイングゲームではなくて、日本のいろいろなアニメとか漫画とか映画とかのエッセンスを取り入れた全く新しい世界を作るようなそういったゲームにしたい。
シェンムーのそのコンセプトとしては、まあ、リアルではなくて、まあ、リアリティでやると。リアリティっていうのを、まあ、そのキーワードというかコンセプトをもとに。
なんかその時はシェンムーチームはなんかラボみたいな研究所みたいなこうワクワク感がありましたね。まあ、
ユウさん曰く、俺が作ったらもっと違う進化してる RPG を作ってやるみたいなすごいことを言ってたんですよ。
You have really two elements happening in Shenmue at the same time. You have this revenge story, but then you have this other thing. You get to interact in a living, breathing world in a place and time that is so incredibly specific.
Age, name, and weight.国籍とか、うん、メイン級の人だと例えば奥さんが何歳でどこの会社に勤めててとか、どう週休2日制だったり。
No one was making an engine that was capable of doing what Shenmue did. They had to make all these textures, make all these assets, design everything from scratch.
By the time this game was ready to go to market, there were 300 people working on this game. This was not an inexpensive game, and the theory was at that time.That it was the most expensive video game ever made.
It was really different at the time because it was a sandbox game, and the fact that you could go anywhere, you could walk into somebody's house, pick up a piece of fruit, and just look at it. And as stupid as that sounds, this was a really big deal when it first came out.
All these mundane things were amazing because for the first time, you could do it in a virtual environment.
PlayStation 2 and the Dreamcast really fought it out for a matter of months before Sega basically had to pull the plug.
They ended up getting Shenmue on the Xbox, which was great, but it kind of got buried after that.
I would like Google it, like whenever it would come up to my mind, I'm like, where's Shenmue? And then I'd find tens of thousands of other people around the world saying the same thing. Where's Shenmue 3? Where's Shenmue 3?
Shenmue 3 has broken the Kickstarter record for the highest funded video game.
Today is very exciting. I hope we can make Shenmue 3 for all the fans. Thank you so much. Thank you.
It's a myth. It's an odyssey that is not yet completed. It's a passion piece that he has to fulfill.
Seeing him able to tell his story touches me more than even my desire to continue the journey.
But I feel like if there's any time for a game like Shenmue to come out, if there's any time for a game like that to come out and to really be groundbreaking, it's now.
ここの4がケイリンっていうところだから、今回シェンムー3がこっち